Well, did you sense hope rising in you? Did you dare to hope as news of vaccines started to come through? There was one to begin with, wasn't there? And then more followed, vaccines which had gone through their tests and were bringing back great results, really high percentages of immunization against COVID-19. It's felt like we needed some good news, hasn't it? And it's felt like after this year, we deserved some good news, something to rejoice in, something to hope in. Well, as Christmas comes upon us, and it comes quickly, of course, Christmas reminds us, the coming of Jesus reminds us that the light that we need in our dark world is not just a COVID vaccine, as much as that is needed. And we're so glad and grateful for those who've worked so hard to make it possible so quickly. But the light we need in our darkness, the light that God sent into his dark world, was not just a vaccine. Of course, he came himself in the Lord Jesus Christ. He came to give us hope, hope that is far, far further reaching and longer lasting, hope that is certain. I don't know whether you get Christmas letters from people who sum up on a side of paper in a few words and a few pictures the kind of year that they've had. Well, we've had a few of those arriving with Christmas cards, and I read one today from some friends, and they ended their Christmas letter with this verse from the end of Romans chapter 15 and verse 13. I thought I'd read it to us and then lead us in a prayer that we might put our hope in the God of hope. So Romans, Paul says this in Romans 13, verse 15. It says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Well, we do certainly pray, don't we, that the vaccine and the plans to roll it out would be effective. But here is a far further reaching, a certain hope from the God of hope, a hope that will fill us with joy and peace as we trust in him. Can I pray that that would be true for you? Let's pray. Our Father God, we do pray for the success of the vaccination plans. Father, we pray for wisdom for our leaders, wisdom for all those tasked with making these vaccinations available, especially to the most vulnerable in our country. We continue to pray, Father, that this vaccination would be made available to people around the world. We pray that there would be equality in the way that it is given out. Father, we pray for strength and for your sustaining for our NHS and medical staff. We pray especially, Father, for the lonely and the grieving this Christmas after such a difficult year. And our Father God, as we prepare to celebrate Christmas and prepare to celebrate the birth of the Lord Jesus, help us to put our hope in him. Would you renew our sense of joy and hope and peace as we dare to put our trust in him? And Father God, we pray all these things in his precious name. Amen. Amen. Well, tonight's little evening devotion, it was deliberately shorter because I've prepared a little video just to explain how we're hoping to keep people safe as we invite you to our Christmas services. So you can watch that straight after this. And do share that if that's appropriate as we invite people to celebrate Christmas with us, either coming to St. Stephen's or watching material and services online as that is available. So thanks for watching, and good night. God bless.